Excuse me, Rue.
Mornings are a busy time for Tag and Lisa Harding of Lakeville, Minnesota. They've had a lot of experience over the years getting five kids ready for school. They were looking ahead to an empty nest in a few years, but things didn't turn out that way. It all started with a missions trip to Africa.
We thought we might work with digging wells in Africa because we knew some friends that had done that, so we thought, well, maybe we could get on board with that.
It turned out they were needed for another project.
And it hadn't occurred to us that God might want us to parent African children.
Now, what are you going to do with James 1:27? What are you going to do about visiting widows and orphans in their distress? That's a question of obedience. And for us, it meant adopting. Have a good night's sleep.
The Hardings adopted little Philip and Zachary from Uganda.
I think that's really cool. That little family in Minnesota and two little boys not even born yet when God started digging on my heart in regards to Africa. And, you know, across the continents and across time zones and all of that, he put a family together.
They're convinced this is only the beginning.
I'm excited about refueling what's already a passion in us, because this is not a period at the end of the sentence now that Philip and Zach are in our house. So now it's what next?
CBN News met with the Hardings in Minneapolis at the Christian Alliance for Orphans Summit.
It's how does God want to use us, and that's the spirit that you see here at the Orphan Summit.
This couple adopted three sets of triplets from Russia, something their biological son is thankful for.
I'm just so amazed at what God has done through the adoptions in our family. It just changed us so much because the three oldest in our family have talked about if we had never had our younger siblings, we'd probably be a lot more self-focused and a lot just have to share and have all the, you know, leading your younger siblings and also just to have a lot of fun as a big family, people counting us, you know, and just drive a massive van. It's just a lot of fun. So we're so blessed by God and just give thanks to Him for that.
Some, like Kyle and Carolyn Tweetmeyer, also take in children considered unadoptable.
These children are HIV positive, and we have a child that was in stage 4 AIDS as well.
CBN's Orphans Promise supports orphanages in Haiti and has built a training facility in Armenia.
It's really exciting to see just the networking and to see how Orphans Promise fits into this whole picture of serving orphans around the world.
Award-winning music artist Stephen Curtis Chapman and his wife Mary Beth have been champions of this cause for nearly a decade. The couple adopted three daughters from China. Their youngest daughter, Maria, died in a tragic accident.
This little girl, you know, God brought her into our family, and for her 5 years on this earth, we thought it was going to be 95 and still we'll wrestle until we see her again and see God with, why wasn't it? That's what we thought was the plan, God. And now this whole new dimension of grieving, and even as we grieve through that process, saying, and this once again brings us back to God's heart for orphans.
And as the Hardings have learned, God's heart for their adopted children has reached deep into their own lives as well.
This story is not about me. I've been asked to join a bigger story, God's story, as it relates to Philip and Zachary.
People have said, oh, aren't they lucky? You rescued them from, you know, whatever. And I think, are you kidding? I'm the lucky one. I get to be their mom, and I get to be daily rescued from my selfishness and my impatience and things that are just as disease-ridden in my soul. So, yeah, I guess I'm the lucky one.
Charlene Israel, CBN News.